Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to work on this Epson ET2760. When we start, I got this system error 202604. Notice nothing moved when we start, so we immediately jump to this error. And also another error is a service required. If you push a button, they give you more info that the ink pad needs service. Contact Epson. There's an ink pad inside the printer that absorbs the waste ink when you do the printer cleaning. It's hiding behind this cover in the back. If we remove this screw, we can take the cover off. And one more screw, we can remove the waste tank. And you can see how much waste ink is in there. It's totally full. You can just go buy a new waste tank, or you can get a kit from BCH Technologies. I'm going to put the link to the product below, and which you have a connector that you plug in to the middle of that ring. Your waste ink will be diverted to this bottle. The kit including a bottle and a Velcro patch. The Velcro patch just for you to put it on the printer so you don't accidentally knock it over. It's not for you to hang this bottle up in the air. Then you just put the tube on it, and in the future, the waste ink will be diverted into this bottle. The price is equivalent to you get a new waste tank, but this one is reusable. Besides this physical solution, you have to reset the ink counter on the printer. To reset it, you go to inkchip.net, then click the WIC. You can see each key is like under 10 bucks. The more you buy, the cheaper it is. When you click English, that's going to download the English version of the software. If you're using Chrome, you're going to see, because this is an unverified download, you have to say, okay, I'm going to keep the download. In our download folder, we can find this Inkchip program. And after we click install, we're going to see a whole bunch of icons on the desktop. And then we select this English version. We can check the waste ink counter. We just click the waste ink counter. You should see your printer list here. If you get a blank list or you cannot find your printer here, there are a couple reasons. One is you need a USB connection. You need to plug in your printer into a USB port, not using Wi-Fi. Secondly, you need to have these printer's driver installed on your computer. Like me, I don't have this installed, so I go to Epson's website and I want to go to ET2760 and I install the printer driver. Most likely, you already have this installed, otherwise you won't use it until your waste pad is full. A word of caution is you'll want to be on the Epson's real website. There are many spam websites. When you search for ET2760 driver, it'll show up like EpsonDriver.com, download EpsonDriver.com, or something similar to Epson, but it's not a real Epson website. I have a friend whose grandma downloaded something she thinks is antivirus software, but itself is a virus software. So the virus software downloaded more virus and asked her to pay like $29.99 per month to clean up the virus. So she's paying to download more virus. So you need to be careful when you download the software on the internet. And now I can see my printer right there. When I see my printers, I know I can go ahead and purchase a key because it's compatible. So I go to inkchip.net and WIC and click buy. And under WIC adjustment program, you can get multiple if you want, if you already said a lot. Like me, sometimes I get 5-pack. And one pack is $10, and 5-pack is like $6 per key. You click add to cart, it's not going to bring you to the cart, but if you see the cart, it become purple or it cut pink, yeah. And click that pink cart, and it's in there. And I usually use my coupon because I buy so much. See if it works, Kevin 9966. And it's going to give you like a 10% off. By the way, Kevin is a small case, Kevin. And then you put your billing information and the credit card info and just click submit. And the key is going to come in really quick, in seconds. So if you buy it, didn't get a key, contact INKCHIP immediately. So click reset and paste the key, click OK, and wait a little bit. I'm not going to fast forward. So let's see, I click and wait, and now it's done. It asks you to restart the printer. So now you can close this window and go restart the printer. Oh, I forgot to tell you, you can click read within the counter and know the current status of the counter. Yeah, you can do it before you buy the key, so you know that was the problem. So now after reset, we can click read within the counter. And you can see the counter is 0. There are two counters because you got two ink pads. Another ink pad you never use is on the plan, and you don't want to change that, or you don't need to change that. And that should solve your ink pad problem. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.